Assalamualaikum students of class 5. How are you all? I hope all of you are safe and well at home. Today I will discuss about chapter 5. I will discuss three topics: the childhood and youth of the Prophet Islam, the placing of Hajar Aswad, and the marriage of Hazrat Muhammad Islam. Let's start today's topic. In our previous class, I discussed about the introduction of Hazrat Muhammad Islam and the birth of Hazrat Muhammad Islam. Now I will discuss about the childhood and youth of Hazrat Muhammad Islam. We know that Hazrat Muhammad Islam's father died before his birth, and after the birth his uncle Abu Lahab's servant Shoaiba nourished him for few days. Then Hazrat Muhammad was given to a lady called Halima of Banu Sa'd tribe, because in that time the high qualified or the honorable Quraysh people gave their little children to the poor Arab people so that they could nourish the child, they could feed the child, and they could teach them pure Arabic language. So Hazrat Muhammad Islam was given to the foster mothers. Foster mothers means the mother who fed a baby, but she is not the real mother. So Halima nourished Hazrat Muhammad Islam for 5 years, and from her Hazrat Islam learned pure Arabic language and achieved good health and good character. He learned justice, truthfulness, etc. Then after 5 years, Hazrat Islam came back to his own mother Amina, and Amina was died when Hazrat Islam was at 6 years old. And after the death of Amina, Hazrat Islam went to his grandfather Abu Muttalib, but Abu Muttalib was died when Hazrat Islam was at 8 years old. Then finally Hazrat Islam was nursed by his uncle Abu Talib. Here we can see Hazrat Islam didn't get much love from his own relative, own mother. As his father died before his birth, then his uncle Abu'l-Lahab's servant Shoaiba nourished him. Then he was given to his foster mother Halima, who fed him milk. And he was with Halima for 5 years old. Then he went back to his mother Amina, but he got his mother's love only 1 year. His mother Amina was died in when he was at 6 years old. Then his grandfather Abu Muttalib nourished him, but he was also died at when Hazrat Islam was at 8 years old. And finally his uncle Abu Talib nourished him. Now look at the youth of Hazrat Muhammad Islam. From childhood, Hazrat Muhammad Islam was very hardworking person. He didn't want to be a burden of his uncle Abu Talib's family, so he looked after his uncle's goats and sheep, and he also looked after his uncle's business. For business purpose, Hazrat Islam went with his uncle Abu Talib to Syria, and here he met a Christian clergyman. Clergyman means padri or religious important person, and his name is Buhayra. Buhayra predicted his uncle Abu Talib that this person, that means Hazrat Islam, will be the last prophet of the mankind, and many people could do harm to him, so be careful. After returning from Syria, Hazrat Islam observed Fizar war. Which war? Fizar war. And this Fizar war was started from Oka's fair. And the reason for this fair is plumbing. And this fair was continued for 5 years. And many people were died and injured in this fair. And for this reason, this fair is called Harbour Fizzle. Okay? After seeing the harmful effect and many deaths of people, Hazrat Islam wanted to bring peace and harmony to the Syria and to the Arab people. For this reason, Hazrat Islam formed or established a peaceful organization, and that peaceful organization is called Hilful Fuzul in Syria, for the peace and harmony, or to establish peace and harmony in Syria. And his social work of Hazrat was praised by everyone. And from childhood, Hazrat Islam was very truthful, honest person, and also faithful, because many people give him amanat. As he was truthful, he is called As-Sadiq, and faithful, he is called Al-Amin. We can learn about many information from the childhood and the youth of Hazrat Islam. As Shoaiba nourished Hazrat Islam for few days, so Shoaiba is the first foster mother of Hazrat Islam who fed him for few days. The second foster mother of Hazrat Islam is Halima of Banu Sa'd tribe. We can learn the placing Hazrat Aswad. Hazrat Aswad is name of a black stone which came from the holy heaven Jannat. And people were engaged in conflict to place the Hazrat Aswad in the wall of the Kaaba, because those tribes who place the Hazrat Aswad to the wall of the Kaaba will be recognized or considered as the honorable to the. There came to a decision by the oldest member of the tribe, Umayyah bin Mubira, that the next morning person who come early in the Kaaba will place the Hazrat Aswad. And in the next morning, Hazrat Islam came to the Kaaba at first, and everyone saw him to be the first person enter into the Kaaba first. Everyone was very glad to see him, because they were sure that Hazrat Islam would take a good decision for them. Then Hazrat took a bed sheet like this, then he keep it this. Then he took the Hazrat Aswad to the middle of the bed sheet and asked all the tribe leaders to cast the each corner of the bed sheet, and all of them do whatever Hazrat said there, and they carried it to the wall of the Kaaba. And finally Hazrat Islam took the Hazrat Aswad and placed it to the wall of the Kaaba. Or in this incident, it is remind us that if we be impartial and wise, we can avoid any unwanted word. And our today's topic is about the marriage of Hazrat Musa. Hazrat Khadija Radhiyallahu was a famous speech, noble and wise woman among the Arab people. He looked for a person who was faithful and who could look after his business. As Hazrat Islam got fame as a truthful and faithful person, Hazrat Khadija Radhiyallahu appointed him as his business man, and Hazrat Islam returned with a huge profit from business. At seeing his honesty, Hazrat Khadija Radhiyallahu wanted to marry Hazrat Islam, and his uncle Abu Talib being as a guardian and conducted the marriage. In the marriage, Hazrat Islam was at 25 years old and Hazrat Khadija Radhiyallahu was at 40 years old. So we can see there is 15 years age gap among Hazrat Islam and Hazrat Khadija Radhiyallahu, but they lived peacefully their married life. And after the marriage, Hazrat Islam never wanted to lead luxurious life, but he spent all the money for the benefit of Islam. That's all for today. See you soon in my next class. Allah Hafiz.